kita tuh nasa kita ini kita dengan tumatahan mo, umano ba yung programa mo, Francis, sa Tacloban? Ako, basta nagkasal sana po, ano mo, safe ang nandit kasi na, tayo sila na po, at bumawa talaga ang pagkatagata ng aking pili. Hindi po ba? Okay, meron po ako yan. Because I talked about the poor, I am in a very good time. So I put it in, how to work it with a lot of pictures, because sometimes pictures speak louder than words. So please, go on. Next, please. Next. So we are focusing in our session on the poor, the marginalized, and the oppressed. Let me say outright that women are the poorest of the poor. Among the poor na sinabi ni Bisha, three categories are niya. Widows, children, and foreigners. And all these are easily women. Widows definitely do marry. Children, a lot of child prostitutes are children. And foreigners, a lot of migrant workers are women. So talaga kita po sa akin kung natin talaga ay maraming kapatulihan. So in spite of the successes of the women's movement in the Philippines, and we really have succeeded in that. We have come a long way. And also for our work with empowerment of women, there's still a long way to go. Okay, next please, because I don't want to take much of your time. So I just want to give a very brief glimpse about the still prevailing plight of women in the Philippines. Next please. There is something called feminization of poverty. The poorest of the poor are women. About 70% of the poor are women. Women's share of unpaid work has increased in most regions, but women still receive 1/3 of men's salary for the same work. Women have poorer access, control, and ownership of resources, such as land and other financial resources. Next, please. Indigenous women have the lowest rates of education and life expectancy and the highest rate of illiteracy, infant and maternal mortality, and death from preventable diseases. Nationally, 35.2% of maternal mortality cases were due to pregnancy complications. There are so many women here. I think there are about 90% of women in this world. So I know you can resonate with me when I'm telling you about the plight of women. Next, please. Domestic violence and rape are the highest recorded incidents of violence against women. 30 cases of violence against women reported every day. Do you know that in this last census, in the latest 2014 after the survey, there has been a 50% increase in reported rape cases. Can you imagine that? 50%? That is from the survey. Next, please. There, you see it graphically. Incest. I think this is a sin trying to heaven for vengeance. Because fathers are supposed to give up their life to protect their children. And if they have to divorce, to destroy their children, isn't that a crime? Crying to heaven for vengeance. It's terrible that there are a lot of incest cases in the Philippines today. We are not just talking about it. Why fatherhood? There are still many cases of that. And you make our crisis center in our city, refuge, one woman told me, na staying with us because she's been battered by her husband. Sabi ko niya sa akin, alam mo sister, sabi ng asawa ko sa akin, Huwag kang sasagot sa akin. Kinuha ka na dito sa akin. Wow! He is choosing theological. I mean, she's just an ordinary person. He is choosing theological. space. According to Gabriela Sauron Mindanao, Secretary General Mary Ann Sapper, said, if not as victims of rape and sexual violence, they are born by soldiers to become their mistresses. Wherever there are armies, whether Filipinos or Americans or whatever, you will really expect that women will be exploited. Next, please. Trafficking of women and children. Almost a million women. This is what Pope Francis and Bishop Ferrer was talking about. Foreigners, not just foreigners, women migrant workers have been employed in the Middle East and Asian countries as domestic helpers, nurses, and entertainers. Just a month ago, I had a guest in my TV show, and the TV show called Nonsense Makes Sense. And you know, I had a visitor that four migrant women who were raped in Riyadh. You remember? The sex for travel na mga babae. Pagkatapos na sila ay in-interview, libro rin yung meeting sa Senate at pala, wala, ano ba yan sila? Wala na nangyayari sa kanila. Wala sila ng hanap buhay, iniwas sila ng kasama nila, nagyan sila na wala ng pagkakitaan. Mabuti na lang, foreign funding agency, ay made the order proposal, binigyan sila ng kapitaan to have a little sari-sari store. But iniwan na sila ng ganyan. Kung hindi natin sila bibigyan ng trabaho, babalik at babalik yun. Not because they like to go away, but because they need to go away. Because wala sila pagpapakayos ng iyong mga anak. Millions of Filipino women and children are trafficked for prostitution. And by the way, you know that human trafficking now is not only for sex, but for organ transplant. I'm sure you have seen that picture of a little girl na tumakbo, like, hinahabol siya sa isang mama. Pagkatapos, hindi naman niya, kinagat niya yung kamay ng mama. Kaya nag-escape siya. Pero nakita niya ang dalawang bata na natin na sa bar na nakahiga. Ang mga kabataan natin, kinitid na pinapatay para alisin yung mata nila, liver nila, kidney nila, para sa organ transplant. That is what happened in our world. Next, please. Yeah, this is that, look at that picture of the women na nasa garapon. Isn't that a very, I don't know how you can say, but it's so scary. But that is the way they are psychologically. Like we need to serve. And those we know, these are child prostitutes. At saka, and that girl there is really kidnapped for organ transplant. Next, please. Next. I am sorry. Oh, they got the wrong copy of my, okay, just go on, because I just continue that. Next, please. So, yan po ang summary ng ating current issues of women. There's inequality, subordination, discrimination of women, go on. Violence against women, and I put there's certain things that are not in the Philippine situation, but in other countries like India and so forth. That part about how we get, honor get, criticize, and get in that situation. I'm sorry, I have no time to explain you. Next, please. And trafficking of women, of course. Next, please. So after the weekend, some are question as to fact that there is discrimination, subordination, exploitation, and oppression of women, as women, that cuts across class, race, creed, nationality, and race. It's an ideological, structural, and global problem. Next, please. Oh, never mind that. You know, this is the wrong version which they put there, but we have no time for that since next. Now, this solution is women empowerment. Next, please. And what is empowerment? And that is the changing of the unequal distribution of power in society. Next, please. Okay, the empowerment is not only economic, but political, social, and spiritual. Next, please. Okay, as I said, this is the long version. I do not want to explain it. Next. But at least you know that there is a thing. Okay. Also, this one is actually it is in my 1 hour lecture. I'm sorry, but it's good for you to see what are the strategies of women and organization. Organization consciousness raising. Gender mainstreaming in the academic, by the way, in Czech, is already mainstreaming gender in all universities in the Philippines. And then, of course, legal strategies, cultural strategies, crisis interventions, and solidarity. Next, please. Okay, just to show you some pictures of organizing. Next. That was me 50 pounds ago, but preaching about women's rights and conducting rallies. Next, please. That was in India that I gave a consciousness raising, but it happens in the Philippines too. Next. And that is our Institute of Women's Studies, because the most important thing for change is not only a change in structure, but change in consciousness. Without change in consciousness, you cannot have a change in anything. Next, please. That is our crisis intervention, that is where women go who are victims of violence and they can stay for about 3 months. So that you know what, when my kid says in Dubai, kahit na ayaw admitin ng nanay, kasi ayaw siya admitin ng nanay na naging incest sa kanya, at ayaw din ihanggal ng tatay, kasi mawawala siya ng halang buhay. Pero ang sakala sa kanila, please, alisipin yung bata ang sa bahay mo yan. Kasi the longer incest happens, the harder it is to rehabilitate them. So we accept them so that they are far away from danger right away. Next, please. So there are many women's alternatives. We have women's studies, feminist theology, her story instead of history lab, feminist counseling, eco-feminism, and alternative media. Next, please. Oh, never mind that. That is again my longer version. But you know that we have been in all these courses in St. Louis as Hispanics, like this. Now, that is another thing that I can explain to you 1 hour. So, next, please. I was in the middle of it. I would like to explain this to you, Sarah, longer, but I cannot. But it is so important because I always say it is not enough to empower women economically, socially, culturally, psychologically. It is very important that they are empowered spiritually. Otherwise, they will never really truly be free. And this is the kind of spirituality that we are developing among our women who are going to us for counseling or for education. The first is self-affirming and individual and community self-affirming spirituality. Kasi kung mga women, kulang ng self-confidence, lagi silang kasama, lagi silang nagsasakripisyo. Pero dapat, they are also self-assertive, affirming. Alam nila na may kakalingan sila, kaya meron sila, weakness, pero magaling sila. I think I should ask every woman here, when you get up in the morning, you look at your mirror and you say, you are good, you are beautiful. You say that to yourself. Thank you. ginawa mo, ang ganda ng project mo. We have really to encourage one another in what we are doing. May kagaya po katulad ng power. Power over equal controlling power. In power corrupts and absolute power corrupts absolutely. Your own self and develop that.